We are live for Iowa Public Radio Classics Steinway Café, presented by Iowa Public Radio and WT&NRM.Trust. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please remember, you can always stream Iowa Public Radio Classic anytime at iowapublicradio.org. My name is Du Huang. This is my wife and piano duet partner Xiao Hu. We are performing this virtual concert from the Noble Recital Hall of Luther College. Take a break from the hectic energy of the world and soak up some classical piano duo music. It's almost the holiday season. We send our warmest wishes to everyone.
The first piece on our program is Sleigh Ride, a Holiday Excursion by Leroy Anderson. It is arranged for two pianos by Greg Anderson. Last year, we opened our holiday concert on Iowa Public Radio with the forehand version. This year, we're going to play a different version for you. The arrangement for two pianos is super sparkling and fun. Let's have a holiday laugh and cheer together. Thank you. Bach composed 6 Brandenburg concertos for instrumental ensembles. They were written between 1708 to 1721. It was dedicated to Christian Ludwig, Margrave of Brandenburg in 1721. These concertos were written in the popular Baroque genre, the Concerto Grosso, in which a group of soloists play together with a small orchestra. We are playing the four-hand version of the 3rd Brandenburg Concerto in G major. It has 3 movements following fast, slow, fast tempo scheme. The music is full of vitality, joy, and energy.
We are particularly excited to premiere a new piece today. America as a nation was stunned by the heartbreaking death of George Floyd on May 25th, 2020. In the protests that followed, American composer Brooke Joyce, who is also a composer and professor at Luther College, was driven to write a new piece to express all the intense feelings he was experiencing. The result is he hung his head and died. 12 variations for George Floyd. Let's listen for a few minutes from composer himself talk about the piece.
My name is Brooke Joyce. I'm professor of music and composer in residence here at Luther College. I've been teaching here for 15 years. In the summer, I've been working on a new composition project that came about after the killing of George Floyd. One thing I think we're all trying to figure out as creative people, as musicians, as artists, is how do we create new work? How do we engage with others when we're living through this pandemic and we're isolated? And for me, making something new, bringing something of beauty and hopefully meaning into the world is a way to kind of combat that sense of isolation that we're all feeling.
Actually, change one note there.
A lot of times when I compose music, I respond to things that are happening in the world around me, and this was an event that really shook me to my core. And so I spent some time thinking about how I might respond as an artist, as a composer, to this event and our history. And the first thing that came to mind was a spiritual that I've known very well for many years called He Never Said a Mumbling Word. And that's the basis for this new piece. Here at Luther, our choral groups sing pieces by African-American composers and pieces from the African-American spiritual tradition all the time. It's part and parcel of what we do. And I've thought a lot about what it means to have someone from a different ethnic background, in my case, a white Caucasian, interfacing with this music. And I feel like what I can do is be a witness to that history and to bring that history into my own work. So when you hear my composition, I don't think you'll mistake it as being anything other than something that was written in 2020 by someone who is engaged with contemporary music. But if you listen very closely, you'll hear that spiritual kind of at the center of the piece. And that's where I hope the music finds a resonance with others.
Thank you.
In 19th century Europe, with the rise of the middle class, making music at home was a very popular pastime. Playing piano duets with family members, friends, and neighbors was a pleasurable entertainment. After Brahms published his hugely popular Hungarian dances for piano four hands, the nationalistic style combined with folklore characteristics inspired many composers from the world, including Edvard Grieg's Norwegian dances. Dvorak wrote a set of Slavonic dances. It was very well received, and his publisher kept asking for more sets. In response, Dvorak wrote From the Bohemian Forest in 1884. It contains six pieces. We are going to play the first three pieces today, In the Spinning Room, By the Black Lake, and Walpurgis Night. In Germany, Walpurgis Night is the night of April 30th to May 1st. It is also the night when the witches are reputed to hold large celebrations on the high mountains and awaits the arrival of spring.
Thank you. Thank you.
Xiao and I enjoyed being with you today. This virtual concert is the result of many people's hard labor. We would like to thank Luther College for the use of their beautiful recital hall, audio and visual producer Mick Layden, piano technician Brian Knox. We would like to thank the outstanding team at Iowa Public Radio, including Lindsay Moon, Chris Fenton, Phil Moss, Bill Wallen, and senior music producer Jacqueline Hoblum. If you know someone who would enjoy this program, please share it with them and follow Iowa Public Radio for future Steinway Café presentations. Happy holidays. Goodbye now.
Happy holidays.